Hey everybody, it's Mike from AMZ Advisors. Today we have a short tutorial for you on adding new users to the Amazon Seller Central account. You're going to do this through using the user permissions section. The user permissions section is located in your Amazon Seller account settings, the top right corner. And from the drop-down menu, you'll select user permissions. You're going to want to use this section to add new users to your account. You know, some of the reasons you might want this is to add, if you have an accountant that's reviewing your books or a bookkeeper who keeps track of things, or various other third-party service providers, you may need to give them access to the account. So this is going to be the way that you're going to do it. You have the ability to control what access within the account they have. So for us, a lot of our clients, we need full access to their accounts. But for example, if they didn't want to give us access to the advertising function, they could, you know, give us access to everything else and block us from advertising. As I kind of mentioned, you know, the reasons why you need this, you're going to want to provide it third-party service providers access sometimes. You may need to set up some certain software that may need access to your account. Another reason to do this is to update information for your brand registry application. When you're going for the brand registry, you need to have an email address on the account that ends in the domain of your website. So for example, if our account didn't have amzadvisors.com, an email at amzadvisors.com on our account, then our brand registry application would be rejected. So this is just the way that you can get that fixed for yourselves as well. So just to show you how we're going to do it, you're going to want to go to your Seller Central account and from the settings dropdown, select user permissions. On the next page, you're just going to enter the email address of the user that you're trying to give access to. You're going to get this message after you send the email. And then once the access has been kind of granted or submitted to this new user, they're going to show up as an invited user on your account. There's still certain steps that need to be taken before they'll actually have access to the account. This is an example of the email that they're going to receive from Seller Central, letting them know what they need to do to get everything completed. They're going to need to follow the steps in here. They're going to need to click go through that link to accept the access, and they'll get a confirmation code, and they're going to need to give that confirmation code to you as the account owner, and you'll verify that code against, you'll see it down here in confirmation codes right there. You'll verify that matches what they give you, and if it does, you can click confirm. You don't necessarily need to do this step. I'm fairly certain it has lined up on every time we've ever done it. But if you want to take that extra step of security, just make sure everything matches, click confirm. Now you're going to want to select what they have access to in your Seller Central account. So click add user permissions. And here you're going to be able to go through each section of Seller Central and determine what they can access, what they can edit, and what they can just view. So, for example, if you don't want them to have access to anything, you're going to select this none column in a particular row. So this is inventory, there's pricing, there's going to be one for advertising, orders, reports, you know, all this stuff. And this is where you can give access to whatever they need and whatever you want them to see. If you just want them to be able to view the inventory, you can select these view options, this view option here. And to edit things, you can give them this permission. To give them full account permission, you can just select the admin at the top of each one. That gives them full access to the account, the ability to change anything, to update things, which, you know, is a lot of times what we need with our clients, and it's definitely something that you might want to use with some third-party service providers. Once you've given everyone the permission they need, you'll be able to move forward by clicking continue at the bottom of the page, and that'll give the user access to everything you had to your account and be able to make any changes or just view information as they need. So that's kind of the tutorial, definitely short and brief to the point, but we hope you learned how to add users to your Seller Central account. If you have any more questions or, you know, want to learn more about what AMZ Advisors can do for your company, please contact us at amzadvisors.com. Also, feel free to check us out on our YouTube page, Instagram page, and Facebook page. Thank you, guys. I hope you have a great day.